One of the more interesting things that I think about are conflict of interest, and this is just financial conflict of interest. And there's lots of settings that now becomes like a real thing that you have to be concerned about, but we don't address those things, right? Like, I'm thinking of where you are supposed to do something that is supposed to be not determined by any sort of financial interest. And yet, whenever there's financial interests that are there, you inherently do something, right? So, almost all of business is set up this particular way. And we don't really make very good judgments whenever this happens, right? So, if we have any sort of financial interest that's in it, we have to sort of think about what are the implications of the decisions that I actually make, right? So, for example, this podcast, I need to, pay developers and those kind of things, so I have a little advertisement at the front of it, but it's not without great ease that or unease that I don't think about this, right? Because that means I might be more swayed, and it's easy to do, very easy to do, to sort of do things that are financially or commercially motivated in some sort of way. And I don't know how to, in business, it's inherent, right? We have this sort of inherent bias that happens. I don't know how to change that to take a step back. But the only thing that we can do whenever you have this sort of conflict of interest that happens is acknowledge it actually exists and go through with the fact that it actually exists. There's two things that you could do, right? So the first one is acknowledge that it actually exists, and it does. There's no way that you can take this away. You can't remove it. It exists. It's inherent in all the transactions that you actually make. And at the margin, doesn't mean like all the time, but at the margin, you're going to be swayed to do something in those financial interests, right? So imagine that you are, selling nails, for example, and you're a nail seller. That's what you sell is like the nails that you hammer into walls. And your supplier says that if you sell a certain amount, we can give you a discount, right? So at the margin, you're going to be very close to that moment where you're going to push nails onto somebody that may not need it and that may not understand what it's about. And when it's that case, you're going to try to do that to dump those nails and to sell more of them, so that you can get that discount, and it'll be cheaper for you to do that. Now, you have to always be conscious of this stuff, and you do this on a regular basis, right? You're gonna do this no matter what, but you have to be conscious of it. And then the other thing is, you might want to be upfront and be actively disclosing certain things, right? Like be okay with disclosing those particular things. I know lots of people don't like to disclose things. They don't think that. So first of all, a lot of people don't think that there is any conflict of interest. They don't see sort of the sort of changes to the decision making that you have, and you can't fix that, right? Like that's the way it's gonna be. If they don't recognize it, well then that's their fault. But on the other hand, if you recognize it, you probably should disclose whenever something that's happening like that, so that other people might be more free about it, or just have like a conversation if it comes up. If somebody sort of mentions it, most people don't care, right? Like 95% of the people don't care about any of this on the buyer and the seller side. But if somebody's buying this from you, if you're buying the nails from somebody else and they tell you about this, or if you're curious about that, you probably should just tell them and be upfront and say, hey, we're gonna get a discount. And then if that's the case, they if they ask for a discount, well then push a little bit of that discount to that, and then it becomes less of a uneasy kind of conversation. But for the most part, you have to be just conscious of it, right? And be aware that that's happening. And yes, it's just quote unquote business, but it does happen, and you have to be just aware of it. And where it matters is not necessarily, it might matter that somebody has excess nails, right? And they're sitting on nails, and it's costing them a little bit of money to sit on those nails. But where it matters is those more life or death decisions, or just things that we have deemed important that required some oversight, right? So that's why there is like conflict of interest, disclosure that happens within medicine, for example. You have to disclose certain things. I don't know the complete ins and outs in terms of what they can accept from pharmaceutical companies, but they have to disclose those because those are really important. That we know about them, we can understand what's going on in science. There's often disclosures that we have to do every time that we submit a journal or submit an article. We have to go through and we have to go through and disclose conflict of interest or anything that happens, right? We just need to be upfront about it, and then people can make their decisions based on that. And there are a lot of cases where it's become a real thing, right? Like in science, the person, and I'm blanking on the person's name that published the article about the link between vaccinations and autism. There was a conflict of interest that was happening there. There were being, which turned out to be completely bogus article in the Lancet, that was later retracted. It was based on very small sample size, but there was also a conflict of interest that was happening there. And it's such a major implication from that. And I don't remember the complete ins and outs, but I remember that there was a conflict of interest that was there. And it's such a major thing that it changed culture and had a major impact on what we do and what we say in terms of vaccinations now. So even though the science was bogus and it was upfront, I think they probably even disclosed it, the conflict of interest, but it still mattered so much that it changed culture. And we have to sort of think about these things to be upfront. And how to deal with them, and to walk through them. There's no moment in your life where you're not going to be swayed by something. Like even when you're having a meeting, for example, right? And the meeting is running long, you know that you should have a nice in-depth meeting, and it's probably going to be really important. In the back of my head, I'm always thinking about, A, I got to get other work done, or B, I want to go home to my family, right? Like, those things are in the back of my mind, and that's kind of inherent conflict of interest that are happening there, right? We have to be just well aware of what's actually happening. And the more that you're just recognize it and you're thoughtful about it, I know that it's like you can go down a rabbit hole, right? And I know that ultimately all decisions have conflict of interest that are inherent in them, but you should be just aware of them, and you should acknowledge that they actually exist, and not shy away from the fact from acknowledging that they actually exist. That's it. So I want to talk about it. I think it's an interesting thing because we all deal with conflict of interest every day. I don't know what the right answer is in any sort of way. I don't know even the philosophers will tell you what the right answer is with this. Maybe I'm sure they have a better understanding than I do. But the disclosure, to being honest about it, being aware of it, those are all the things that you sort of mitigate these issues as much as you possibly can, so that other people can make decisions based on that. They'll realize that, wait a minute, maybe the person that's selling me nails is pushing to me because I can get a discount. And so just be well aware of those things. They happen all over every sort of decision that you make, purchasing decision. There's always something that's happening behind the scenes. And so just be cognizant of it. That they're pushing you stuff, right? Like, that's what you have to remember, is nobody is up front. They're selling you stuff, and just be well aware. Be careful, is what I'm saying. All right, take care. Have a wonderful day. Bye.